7, 6, 5.
A very, very special, intimate, and interactive featuring the biggest band in the land. We're talking about the Spice Girls. They're so huge, we had to shut down Queen and John. We're talking about a band that has sold over 31 million records worldwide. And the only way to kick it off is with all you beautiful people here. If you're feeling all right, let me hear you say, Spice Girl! Here they are, live, come on in!
Second release that we had, which is Say You'll Be There. So join in, sing along, and go for it. Yes!
Yes!
we're going to party.
Well, we want to see you dancing in the streets out there.
Yes. What are we doing?
Well, you know when it
Fight
comes.
With me live.
But I'll do this.
They're kicking in. You look great, you look fabulous.
Thank you. We want to say a big hello to everybody out there.
Hello!
Something has to start flying.
Anyway, we're going to do introductions.
On my left-hand side would be...
I'm Victoria.
Better known as Posh Spice. Still on my left
Hello,
would be...
Hello, everybody. This is Emma.
All right.
Hello, everybody. I'm Melanie Mel B. All
right. And I'm Melanie C. All right.
Well, what we like to call it is an intimate and interactive. You get to interact with all these cats that are here. How you feeling, everybody? You feeling all right? But also, we're going to get to interact with some of the people outside. So I'm just going to stay right here. I'm going to head outside there. All right? No, you guys stay here. I just want to come.
Oh, I want to go.
Come on, let's go. Let's go. Come on, let's go. Let's go say what's up. Come on.
Can you get my camera? My camera.
Look at those cameras go. Kids on the roof. All right. Well, you've seen them. They look fabulous, don't they? Wow.
See you all soon.
Isn't that great? Now you're left with me. All right. How you guys feeling? You still feel better? So you should. All right, now, those people at home that are enjoying the Spice Girls Intimate and Interactive can get in touch with us. Here's the digits. If you're at home, phone, fax, email, here they are. Spice Girls, and let me just come out and just talk to some of the cats that are around here. All right, now you know what? Who was at the show? Who was at this concert last night? All right, let's get a young man. Okay, young man, let's get you in the light here, little fella. What's your name?
Alex.
All right, Alex, how old are you?
11.
All right, I know you held back on the age. Good work. All right, so Alex, how was the concert last night?
Great. I didn't go.
You didn't go? I just
I thought you said anybody. I don't know.
Oh. I said, did anybody go to the show? But you didn't go to the show. Oh, okay. But you've enjoyed what you've seen so far, though, right?
I did.
Okay, yeah. Good. All right. You grab a little seat there, my man. All right, the ladies are back. Make some noise for the Spice Girls as they return. Woo! All right. Oh, look at that then.
Hey.
Wow. Ooh, like
I love
good...
that.
Which one? That little guy there?
Oh, he's kind of cute.
All right, well, you know what? It's good seeing you guys. Last time I hooked up with you guys was at the premiere, yes?
Yes.
New York, New York City?
Yes.
For Spice World, yeah. So that was kind of cool. It's good to have you back here in Canada.
I
guess another thing, too, later on we're going to find out Spice Girls' hidden talents.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What's that then?
Well, that's later on. But I get the first. I get the first question, and I know when you guys started out that you wanted to be successful. You know,
yeah.
you wanted this to happen. You wanted to be stars, and now it's definitely a Spice World out there. So, what do you think the difference is now that you guys are so worldly and you've been all over the place? What's the difference for you in terms of what you see now?
I think you know we're so lucky. It's like all our dreams have come true. Do you know what I mean? I think one of the best parts of being a Spice Girl is like, it's days like today because we get to go all over the world, fantastic countries, and meet all our great fans.
And I know that in terms of like, how do you keep grounded? How do you keep, you know, egos in check and everything together?
I think we keep each other grounded, obviously our families as well. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, but
I think
families are, yeah.
Yeah, and you know, we like to do the normal things and go shopping and stuff like that. So we are quite grounded people. Because I think because, you know, we've had to work so hard to where we come from. We, you know, before we were on the social security, we had no money. We were living off beans on toast and living in a house together. You know, so I think when you've come from that and you've worked hard to come where you are, you never forget your roots.
I think,
this
know,
doesn't work.
Oh, let me see that. Maybe you have to put money in here. What's let me figure it out. Here, pass it over.
You have to put money in.
Just twist the little thing in it. Oh, that's it.
Are these sweets?
Oh, yeah, they're sweets.
Oh, right.
The candy
buttons. Do you eat them just like that?
Okay, you know what we're going to do? I'm going to jump over here and take an audience question, all right?
Okay.
You, you guys stay right there. I'll be wanting to
put your hand. Out of your hand.
All right. Let me just
How
get right
get
in
them
there.
Off?
Just
off.
Pop right in here and just say hello.
So, hello.
Hi, who are you?
My name is Nora, and I came from Ottawa.
Hey.
Hiya. Is that your hair?
Thank
you. Actually, this is a letter. I work at a camp, and the kids that my group, they made this for you. They wrote you a letter. And my question is, do you think that you've had a lot of influences on other girl bands?
I think... Oh, sorry.
No, go ahead.
No, I was going to say that, you know, when we first started out, it was very difficult for girl bands. I mean, we couldn't even get on the front of a magazine cover, because everybody said that, you know, a girl band would never sell a magazine. And now it's great to see lots of girl bands out there all doing well. And I wouldn't say that we feel responsible, but, I mean, we are so pleased to see that. It's wicked.
About time, because before there was a lot of boy bands everywhere. I think it's nice to have more girl bands, because it's nice for girls to be doing it for girls, and it's good for female solidarity as well.
Question?
Yes, thank you so much.
All right, okay, you know what? We have...
I'm going to get this lady on camera because she's trying to tell you something. What are you trying to tell him? Speakers on Road.
That's right, Halifax.
Halifax,
thank you
okay?
Very much.
Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you. Because otherwise, I'd be just standing there. I'd be lost. Okay, I can go now, because I know where I'm going. I'm going Speakers on the Road, and you don't know what that is, though, do you? You know what it is?
Yeah, no.
Someone out there. Yeah, we've got Speakers Corner. You know what's going on.
I know what's happening.
But you know, we have Speakers Corner all over. You go into this little booth, you put in a loony, which is like a dollar.
All right.
And then you get to open up and say whatever's on your mind, politics,
sex. That's a really good
idea. Sex, the dollar
goes to charity. Really good idea.
Yeah, it goes to charity.
Good.
So what we do, we have Speakers Corners on the road, and we're going to take a question, and I think it's coming from, let me just grab it here, it's coming from Halifax. So let's check out the question you guys
Halifax.
Hi, I'm Janie.
I'm Shmara. And we're from Halifax.
And we're wondering if you still talk and hang out with Ginger, even though she's not a Spice Girl anymore.
Yeah, I mean, you know, everybody says that, you know, we're still getting on with Jerry. And I mean, we still talk. We're all still friends. And, you know, whatever she wants to do, we wish her luck in. And we're sure she'll do great. But, we still get on well with her. And we do still speak.
We haven't seen her, obviously, for a long time, because we're over there.
Been away.
And she's busy doing her things. But we're also mates at the end of the month.
What exactly?
There's another one. Jessica Bone.
we're gonna get to that in just a quick flash.
Is that your girlfriend?
No, Jessica? No.
Ooh, it's his Jessica? Mummy's ready.
Yeah, right. Get some milk. All right, you know what? So what I was gonna ask you, following up the Jerry thing, was, what exactly happened?
We're not going to tell you, are we?
Come on.
I think, you know, basically what happened is that, you know, Jerry just decided it was time for her to move on. You know, she's got lots of other things that she wants to do. You know, but us four are still happy working as a band. So, you know, she's just gone on and done her own thing, and we wish her luck. And that really is what happened. I think everybody wants to hear a lot of nitty gritty, but there really wasn't any. And we're still friends. And
Was it a little nervy for you guys? I mean, you know, it happened just before you were actually going to go out on tour. So
for my birthday.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, happy belated birthday.
We actually had
to. Wasn't it?
Yeah, we actually had to, like, 2 hours before one of the shows we were going to do in Oslo. And, you know, luckily, you know, for very professional, we got on. We had to, you know, redo a couple of vocals, stage a couple of numbers. But, I mean, we literally had 2 hours, and we got it done, and the show was brilliant that night, so we were proud of us.
I've got you a present.
You got me a present? Oh, what is that? Mel B, what's next?
What's next? Jessica is on the phone.
Thank you, Mel.
Hi, Jessica.
Jessica, how are you?
Jessica!
Hello, Jessica.
Is this live?
Oh, yes!
Hey! And we can do whatever we want!
Well,
and no one's on the
phone! We're quickly writing new stuff now. Okay, let me ask you a question. Okay, now one thing that happens to you guys is, I mean, the British tabloids are like, I mean, they're nuts. There's no twins. But I mean, I saw the whole thing, that double-page pictorial of you and one of your ex-boyfriends on a beach or something.
Oh, no, that is my boyfriend.
Now. Oh, he is now?
Same one, yeah.
Oh, okay.
One on.
Oh, whatever. But anyway.
No, I got caught sunbathing.
Yeah, you were sunbathing.
In France,
no,
yeah.
Well, actually, you were walking and they had pictures of you and your little, whatever they call those things. Little things.
G-strings.
There you go. And then there was nothing up here. You were like topless and stuff. But, I mean, apart from that, I mean, what's the craziest thing? What's the craziest thing in terms of the tabloids? Like, what have they done to actually try and capture a picture of you guys?
They will go to any extent, won't they?
They go to anything. But I think one of the funniest things, they had a ladder up where I live to try and get pictures in of my bedroom.
Oh, yeah?
But yeah, so they do go to... But the thing
that's
is...
That's a little freaky, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
Now, I tell you what's scary, sometimes, scary, but as well as that, sometimes, like, you can be on holiday and stuff, and then a few days later you'll see photographs in the newspaper, and you didn't even know that they were there.
That's right.
Do you know what I mean? And that's when you think, it's like someone's spying on you, do you know what I mean?
I mean, they hang from trees and all sorts to get pictures, and as Melanie said, it's scary, the thought that someone's watching you all the time.
But I think
but
the
who
law
cares,
should,
eh?
I think the law should tighten up on them even more.
Definitely.
Yes.
Go, Melanie.
Well, we're going to take an email question.
I want to know where Jessica is on the phone. What happened to her?
We're still looking for her. We're still looking for her. We have an email question. So you look at this monitor here. And it's going to say, Dear Spice Girls, and much, of course, I have a love problem. That would be a love problem. And don't know what to do. Please give me some advice. I really like this guy named Christian. And I already broke up with him 6 months ago. And since then, we finally became friends again. Now I want him back. What should I do? I don't know. I don't want to ruin our friendship. What would you do if you were in my position? Love, Erica.
I wouldn't push it. I would just stay as his friend and see what happens from there.
Yeah. Right.
I think, you know, things like that, it can really ruin a friendship, can't it? You know, if you make a mistake and think you want it to be something else. But just go with the flow and see what happens. Don't force anything. Just... do what feels natural.
I've got a friend.
Can
sit on my knee?
Look at that.
It's a baby, Mel B.
What's your name?
I want him.
What's your name, sweetheart?
What's your name? Taylor. Taylor.
Taylor. Oh. All right, there. Okay, you sit right there and you just chill out. Have some candy.
Do you want some sweets?
All right, the other thing I was going to ask about in terms of your relationship, like, we know you're getting married.
Yeah.
Right, next year.
Yeah.
All right, look at you glowing. Look at the big marriage. Look at that, eh? So that must be really exciting.
Yeah, I'm very, very happy with getting married next year.
All right. How about,
yes? What do you want?
And if we don't know by now, who are you getting married to? Come on, everybody knows, but they would like to hear you say it. Is he here?
He might, you know.
Yeah, bring him
there
on!
He is. Come on, get over here, David. Get over here.
David,
get over here, David.
David!
Did he run?
David!
Is he gone?
He's gone.
Yeah, he's shy. All right. Now, what about you ladies? Are the rest of you all single, or... Because Mel, I heard that you're
free. Free.
You're free?
Yeah.
All right, what about yourself, Emma?
She's not telling.
You're not telling? Well, now, that to me looks good. Like, you're definitely hooked up. I mean, that whole tent-turning thing. And, Melby, are you still engaged, or what's the deal with that?
I'm not telling you.
You're not telling me?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, you're still engaged?
I am.
Oh, good.
Oh, good.
No, that's good. When is that how I happened?
You fancy her, don't you, Master T?
Do I fancy her?
Yeah, I heard you yesterday.
You know what? The reason
why
I fancy her is because she's a sister from Leeds, and I'm from Leeds, too.
Hey!
Leeds! There's roots there.
I saw you yesterday on the telly, and you asked... who was your favourite Spice Girl? And you said Mel.
Oh, can we give me a kiss then?
Right,
I like that.
Do I help you?
Mwah. Whee! You smell very nice, actually. You smell
shower
very
always
nice.
Helps, I
does anybody remember last time we were here and we made Master T show his pants?
Oh.
Did
yeah.
That was last time. We have a fax. It's always important to keep things fresh. This year I got a kiss and
facts.
Oh, I got the facts in
you
my head. Where's the facts?
You flash on this with your emails, faxes.
That's how we work. That's why it's intimate. It's interactive.
Hey,
right,
facts.
So, okay, yeah. So Hello Much Music and Victoria, Mel, Emma, and Mel C. On Friday, I went to a concert in Montreal. It was a great concert, even though our seats sucked. My question is about your concert. I wanted to know how you decided who would replace Jerry's parts in the songs. I thought you did a great job because you only had a few days to do this. I was also wondering... who do you think has the most girl power in the group? This comes from Tyler in Orleans, Ontario. Who has the most girl power?
That's a long one, isn't it? Where do we start?
How did we decide who was going to sing? Yeah.
It was when we came to redoing the show, like we said, we had 2 hours before one of our European shows to do it. And it was just quite natural. Like whoever, you know, could sing that part, you know, if it fitted their vocal range and stuff like that, you know, and how it worked in the choreography. So that was quite simple. But as for girl power, I think we've all got loads of girl power in different ways.
Right, it seems like you've all got the girl power. Okay, now, by the end of the show, is she going to transform into really... because, all right, we've got Jessica on the line. Hello, Jessica.
Jessica!
Hello!
Hi, Jessica! Yay!
Hey, you're winners!
Hi.
All right, Jessica, what's your question?
Before I ask my question, I just want to say that you guys are really cool. And I think that it's really awesome that you guys are, like, moving on without Jerry and stuff. And girl power all the way, man.
Thank you.
Okay.
I'm glad you found it.
I want to ask them, how do you guys feel about being a role model for millions of girls? Like, they look up to you and they do everything that you do. Like, and kind of secondly with that, has it changed you as a person in any way, knowing that people look up to you?
I think you don't actually realize that you are a role model until, like, you meet the fans and you talk to them and you hear what they have to say. Mm-hmm. I mean, not so long ago, we met, like, a group of fans before the show, because we do meet and greet, and this girl had actually pierced her tongue and it had gone wrong. And she did it because I'd got a piercing. And when things happen like that, you think, oops. It's like, oh, I didn't realize how much of an effect that we have. But obviously, we have to realize to a certain extent, because we have a responsibility. And we like to write about a lot of positive things for the young children that are looking up to us.
I think, you know, obviously as well, it is hard to look in the mirror and say, you know, you don't understand that you are a role model. But then again, you know, we are positive about everything we do. We're not perfect. We're not tall, skinny models. Do you know what I mean? So in a way, it is quite positive for children, I think, to see that, you know, we're not perfect. We do get spots. We do get big bums and stuff.
Does it add, thank you, Jessica.
Okay, thanks.
Does it add to the pressure? I mean, when you guys first started out, I mean, marketing, people knew that you were going to hit, like, the teenager 12 to 16 mark. You knew that. But now, I mean, she can't be any more than, what, 6 or 7? I mean,
she's four.
4 years old.
Wow.
You see what I mean? So now, I mean, like, does that add to, you know, your responsibility? I mean, knowing that this is a little young cat who's 4 years old?
I think so. But, I mean, our fans, if you, you know, come to one of our shows, it's such a cross-section. And, like, we've got, like, the 4 years like this. And then we've got, like, grannies and grandads.
The mums and...
They're all loving it. And it's, you know, it's something that we're really proud of.
Here's your fact. It's funny because some of the mums and dads know more words than the actual kids do. It's funny because as like the show goes on, you'll see them properly boogieing. Like the dad will be funny. Up dancing
away. The dads are like that at first. The dads are like, no, what am I doing here? And then by the end of it, they're up dancing.
But it's funny, sometimes you see the children are with the parents and they're like that, really embarrassed, because like the mum and dad are going for it like that, and they're like, Mom.
All right, you know what we're going to do? I'm going to run to the window. I'm going to take a question for you guys.
Yay.
So you guys stay there, listen up for the question. All right, I'm going to head back outside here. All right. All right, I'm going to play on the window. Hey, how you doing? Thank you. All right, here's the deal, all right? I want you to get all your spice energy out, because we're going to take a question, and I need it to be quiet, all right? So, you ready for the spice energy? On the three count, let me hear you say, spice. 1, 2, 3.
Spice!
Thank you. All right. All right, you have a response. What did you want to say?
Hi, I'd like to say I love you, and you guys are like an inspiration. Like, you guys are my role models. And when Mousy said, then you can...
Where is she?
It's all right, sweetheart. It's all right.
Don't cry.
Okay, hang on.
Go and get a little bit of
Mousy. I
want
to go
and see her. Okay,
great. She wants...
Okay, they're going to come out and talk to you. You all right?
If you give this to Mousy.
Okay. All right, guys. I know, right? So that's what you do. That's the effect you guys have on people. That's amazing. All right. Okay. If we could just keep it down for 1 second, we're just going to take this question right here. Let me get you. What's your name?
Robin.
Okay, and your name?
Tommy.
You guys have been here since Friday sleeping up. Okay. All right, here she is. Okay, what's that? Where's Brody?
Oh, darling, don't cry, hello. You all right? Woo, this is mine.
Okay, you know what, we're gonna get the question. Okay, what's the question?
We were wondering, okay.
Okay, keep it down for me, please. We're gonna take this question, thanks.
We really love you guys, and we saw how you go all over the world on concerts and stuff and running. How do you spend time for your family and friends at home and all the regular stuff you like to do?
Okay, you want to head back inside? Okay, they're gonna answer the question for you inside. You guys got the question, right?
The thing is, we stay in touch with our families by phone. Our phone bills are ridiculous.
Huge.
And they come out and see us a lot, and we go and, you know, we just see them as much as we can. And
there's my mum!
And there's Mel's mum! So we do keep in touch as much as we can, and but you know, obviously we'll be going home soon as well, spend some time at home.
Okay, thanks ladies. All right, Ricky Youngcat, or Rick the Temp, is out there amongst you guys. What's up, Ricky? How you doing?
Thousands of Spice Girls fans surrounding us. What's your name?
I'm Joy.
This is Joy. And Joy, you have a question for the Spice Girls?
Yep. I want to know, what is the best part about being a Spice Girl?
Best part about being a Spice Girl? Spice Girls, can you answer that one?
Is that you?
No.
I'm saying that, you know, there are lots of really, really good things about being a Spice Girl. One is the fact that, you know, obviously we are really, really close and really good friends. And that is wicked. We travel around the world and we meet some fantastic people. And we have fun all the time.
Little boys are going to sit under
and
me.
And lots of sweets.
He went like this. No!
Okay, so we're gonna head on the road again, and speakers put it on the road, and we're gonna take another question for you guys, and we're gonna go to Montreal.
Woo, Montreal!
Where is he? You're welcome to sit on your knees.
Hi, my name is Myriam Rochelot from Montreal. If each of you could have a dream date with anyone in the whole world, who would it be and why?
All right, who wants to go first? All right, then, go on.
Either Leonardo DiCaprio, or is it Matt Damon?
Yeah, Matt Damon.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Dream date?
Matt Damon.
Okay.
From
Goodwill Hunting.
My dream date would be Matt LeBlanc from Friends, because he makes me laugh, and that's really important, I think. A man should make you laugh.
All right.
Oh, I've got my dream date, haven't I? I'm all right.
Well, you can still have somebody out there that...
No, I haven't. I'm salted.
Yeah?
I'm
all right.
Barry Manilow.
Barry Manilow?
No, I'm salted.
Okay. All right, there, Mel.
I'm trying to make Paula laugh, but she's not laughing at me, are you?
She's going to go home.
Melanie likes Denzel Washington.
Yeah.
Denzel?
If it wasn't my man that I'm with now, it'd probably be somebody like Denzel Washington. He's quite...
But
riff,
could you guys actually go on a regular date, though? I mean...
We go out. We go out quite a lot.
Sometimes. When we're not busy.
All right, cool. But you know what we're going to do? There's going to be lots more with you guys, and we're going to come back after this commercial break, because we are featuring today the Spice Girls. Interactive. Interactive featuring the Spice Girls. Make some noise, everyone in the house. How you feeling? You all right? Good. All right. So one thing I want to talk about, I mean, I've heard that you guys have a live album coming out. Is that going to be happening?
It's something that we've talked about, isn't it? It's a possibility, yeah. But actually, we're working on our third album at the moment.
Right. Okay, are you writing on the road and stuff like that, or...?
We're getting ideas together, but really we're going to wait until we get home, get into the studio, and hopefully it'll be out early next year.
Okay. How do you balance it in terms of, like, writing? I mean, there's four separate...
It's really easy.
Yeah?
Like, one comes up with a melody, one will come up with an idea, somebody will come up with, like, the story vibe with it. It's really, really, like, easy, because at the end of the... I think four heads are better than just one. You don't get carried away.
It's a real vibe thing with us, you know. We get in the studio and we have a good time, and, you know, that's what it's all about, really. It's all about having fun and enjoying ourselves, and we can't wait to get back in the studio, really, can we?
All right, cool. Now, we have a couple of audience questions, and on my left-hand side, introduce yourself.
I'm Sarah. I'm from Winnipeg.
All right. Hi.
All right. Did you come all the way here just for this?
Hello.
Yeah.
Winnipeg. No, good for you. Okay, your question is for who?
Okay, my question is, if you could be any other spice, like not like trade spices, but like if you could just choose a whole new one, what would you choose?
I think we'd all like to be lazy spice.
Sloppy spice.
Yeah, we work so hard and
in
some
bed
days...
asleep spice.
Yeah. Boring spice.
Sit in your room and watch TV all day, Spice.
No, but I think really we're all pretty happy with our little nicknames, aren't we? And we like being the spices we are.
What's this? Is this your bedroom?
Wow.
This? Where's the camera gone?
Oh, look. That's your room? Oh, you're like a spiceologist there.
That's scary. Imagine waking up to that every morning.
All
right, you know what? We're going to head on the road again. We're going to take a speaker's corner question. So listen up, because we're going to head to Vancouver, B.C.
Hi, I'm Stacy.
And I'm Cher.
And we're from Vancouver, and we love the Spice Girls. And we want to know who designs their shoes, because they are so cool.
All right, who's first?
Well, me and Vicky are from Buffalo today, aren't we?
Just for today, yeah.
Today, Vicky doesn't normally wear things like this. She normally wears the stilettos.
The stilettos. Where are the stilettos today, darling?
I left them at home today because I'm dancing a lot, you see, so I thought it would be a bit more practical.
That makes sense, that makes sense.
You'd understand, you know, when you're dancing all day.
Oh, I'm with you, because I left my stilettos at home too. But anyway,
I got mine on.
Kidding.
I am usually Buffalo, but these are Prada.
Oh.
Ooh.
But I'm usually Buffalo, special ones.
The girls all wear silly shoes. I only wear trainers, sneakers. But I think a lot of the shoes in the show are actually made by Shelley's, which is a London company.
Yeah. I've got Buffalo as well.
Okay. All right. You know what we're going to do now? We're going to head to email.
Email.
You're with me, aren't you? All right. So we got an email question. And it says, hello, Spice Girls. I'm a big fan of yours. And I know that you are fans of Madonna and are influenced by her. My question is, if someone was to do a Madonna tribute album and they asked you to do a song, what song would it be? And
this is Melanie's the big Madonna fan. She'll have to answer that one.
Dan from Thunder Bay.
Oh, that's a tough one. There's actually a Madonna song, one of my favourite Madonna songs. It wasn't actually released in England. I don't know if it's released here. It's called Bad Girl. It's off the Erotica album. I'd like to do that.
Are you bad?
Ow! I'm real bad. Melody like a virgin.
And let's go on to our facts quickly. All right, so we have the Spice Girls. Facts says, hi, ladies. Where do you see your careers in 5 to 10 years? P.S. Congratulations to Posh on her engagement, and girl power, forever fans, Lenore and Garth. All right.
Well, thank you very much, firstly. But I think, the most important thing to us is our friendship, and that's one thing that will definitely still be going in 5 to 10 years. We'll all still be very good friends. You know, professionally, I don't know. Maybe we'll be doing bits and pieces on our own, but, you know, still working together would be great.
I think there'll always be music coming out of the Spice Girls, always, because that's what we're about, and that's what we love so much.
She herself as like producers and stuff.
Is my mic working?
She doesn't need a mic because she's got a loud voice.
Why am I turned down?
I had nothing to do with it.
I am now because it's very quiet.
All right, we have another phone call. It comes from Rachel. Rachel, how are you?
Fine.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. What's your question, Rachel?
I would like to know, Mel B and Mel C have Chinese tattoos, and I would like to know what they represent.
I've got some new ones, actually. I've got an additional one, I'll show you.
All get them out.
Well, let's see them. Oh, okay. We got a show?
That one means freedom and liberation. That one means spirit, heart and mind. And this one means elegant lady. Hope you haven't got a close-up on my belly.
All right.
Man, I've got two characters on my shoulder. And the top one says woman, and the bottom one says strength. So it's girl power.
You've got it as well. Is that similar?
Thank you very much.
We love you guys.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're going to head outside and we're going to find Rick. And Rick has a question because he's amongst the crowd.
Rick.
What's up, Rick?
Hi, Rick.
Come on, Rick.
Hey, thanks, Master T. Thanks, Master T. You guys have been here for a long time. Long, long time. What's your name? Where are you from?
Andy Hall from Mississauga.
And Onika Jackson.
And someone's holding up Emma Spice back there. Emma, I mean, baby, you got his hands. Now, do you have a question for the Spice Girls?
You guys have been such great role models for girls of all ages around the world. I just want to know, who are your role models now, and who were they when you guys were growing up?
You got that?
Yeah.
Thanks, Rick.
Okay, guys.
I think individually we've got different role models we're going along, but I think for mine, when I was growing up, my mum is a very strong female, and I look up to her a lot.
Here for the mums, man.
Hey, for the mums.
They hold it down. Let's hear it. Come on.
Girl power to the mums.
I think when I was growing up a lot, I listened a lot to like Nina Cherry and Tracy Chapman, that kind of thing. But now I just kind of respect anybody who's up there doing their own thing and doing whatever they believe in. So really, I'm quite a wide range of people.
Lady Diana, I'd say. Yeah, I mean, she had girl power and,
I think one of my, like, main inspirations in my life, we've already talked about, is Madonna. But then there's other, like, really strong female artists we really look up to, like Tina Turner and people like that.
Yeah. Lily Savage.
I think, you know, they don't have to be famous or in the public eye. You know, we feel that, you know, there's lots and lots of people who are really strong around. It doesn't have to be. It can be a one-parent mother.
Our makeup lady, Karin's pretty good. She is.
Girl power.
She's got girl power.
With four of us.
All right.
And kind of handle all that.
Well, that must be an easy task, though, eh?
No, it's not.
All right, no, you know what? We're going to... can we do the hidden talents now?
What is this hidden talent?
Okay, all right. Okay, well, here's the deal. Now, what would you say your hidden talent is?
I know what it is.
Mine's so hidden, I don't know what it is myself.
Okay, so we're going to start with you, Mel B.
Why me?
Because we're going to start with you.
Melanie can play the drums.
That's right. Let's go.
No.
Come on. Let's go. Come on. You're a drummer. Let's go. So, like, I heard you trained. Like, I mean, like, professionally trained. Or is that...
When I was about 8 years old.
Well, that's good now. You're only like...
That was like ages ago.
Okay, let's go over here. There's a nice little drum kit over here. Oh, it's a good one, too. All right, so go ahead over
here. I might not be allowed to go on that.
Sure
that's
you can.
Andy's.
Where's the drummer?
Andy, please say no. I'm not allowed.
Is the drummer here? He's not even here. Come on, he's having a sandwich. Go over here. All right, right in there. We'll get you some drumsticks.
I'm not very good anymore.
Oh, come on. Just hold the beat down, baby. Come on. Okay, here we go. All right, these are sticks.
All right, wait a minute.
All right. Okay, you know what we got to do, right? So everybody in the house, you got to help us out, all right?
Better be good, Melanie.
Okay, hold on, baby. I'm going to give you something to work with, all right? All right, then. Go, Scary!
Go, Scary!
Go, Scary!
Go Scary.
Go Scary. Go Scary. That was good. Okay, come on, let's go back then.
And I want to know who put you up to that.
Nobody. Come on, it's all about research, babe. Come on, follow me here. That was good, though. You could really hold down a beat there.
That's what I was thinking.
You really know how to... You know, in case your drummer gets sick, you're always there. You know what I mean? All right, let's keep walking. Come on, follow me. Okay, hi, young guys. You all right? These guys look so cool.
Oh, look,
so
there's
cool.
A Mel C doll there.
Huh?
There's a Mel C doll.
All right, let's go. We got to move quickly. It's expensive television narrative.
Got to move quick. The next hidden talent is who?
All right, it is. It's, well then, Victoria. How are you?
I'm fine. What's mine, then?
So what is your world record for juggling?
Do you know what? I'm not really that good, but...
Okay, what do we start with? Do we start with one ball or two balls?
Three.
Oh, three. Okay, here we go.
Go, Vicky.
All right, you ready? Oh, that... Whoa! Oh, that's good. Okay, you know what? Okay,
now... Not bad.
No, stand up. We're going to go for the world record. So we're going for four. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's good. All right. So hold that. I'm going to give you that. Okay, so four. You can do four. You can do... Okay, all right. So we're doing the whole hidden talent thing here. All right, there, Miss Baby Spice. Come here, man. All right. Come on. I don't know if you can do it, though, because... because let's go over here.
I know what you have to do.
What is it? Oh, I forgot.
Eat.
So,
what have I got to do?
Oh, just follow me and I'll tell you, all right?
Eat sweet.
So, I don't know if you can do it, though, because you've got, like, this little outfit on. But I heard you, like, you know, some sort of martial arts.
Oh, yeah, I do.
Oh, you see? Oh, or you tap dance, but these aren't exactly the
I can tap dance for you.
Okay, well, show me some tap dance martial arts moves.
Do you want to tap dance or martial arts?
Okay, well, let's see the tap dance first.
Okay.
Tap dance. Oh, that was good, eh? Okay, so martial arts. Now, what can you do?
That was crap.
It's gonna be hard for you to kick me, I mean, in a skirt. Maybe. Let's see, I came at you.
This is a punch.
Okay, do you want to put my hands up like this? You want me to put my hands up here?
Ooh.
Ooh. Oh.
Wow. Ooh, that wasn't very good. I don't think you need to do a high kick.
Okay. All right, that really hurt.
High kick, high kick, high kick, high kick.
All right, so when we come back after the break, we're going to find out what Sporty Spice's hidden talent is when we come back here with the Spice Girls Intimate and Interactive on Much Music. Welcome back to the Intimate and Interactive as we feature the Spice Girls. And before the break, we were checking out some of the hidden talents of the ladies. And we have one more hidden talent to discover, and that would be...
Melanie C.
Yes, Mel C.
I can grow blue hair like that. There it is.
that was good. All right, you know what it is? I heard it's like hockey. There you go.
Do you know what? I really don't know where that's come from.
Well, you know what? If it's a lie, you got to do it anyway.
I'll have a go.
We spent a lot of money on these sticks.
Hockey.
Let's go. So you know what?
I've always been rubbish at hockey. I was better than netball.
You're better than netball?
Mm.
All right. Well, you know, netball, hockey, it's all the same, isn't it? All right.
It's good because you can whack
the puck.
People's ankles.
Here's the puck. Okay, I'm going to be the goalkeeper. So I don't know how I'm going to hold the mic. And all right, so what you're going to do is, well, actually, you got to back up because I don't want to get hurt. All right, so I'm going to be in net. All right, hold on here. Let me get my hockey stance. Ready? Have a shot. Well, I know.
Hey!
Okay, all right, all right, all right.
She didn't know she was good at hockey, but she
I'll
is.
I'll give you one more shot, all right? Because that was just a little bit of a fluke. Okay, wait, hold on.
You meant to close your legs.
I know, that's the whole thing.
Just went straight between.
Now I got to get my hockey stance, all right. Okay, have a seat. Thank you. Sit down, relax.
Melanie!
Yeah,
all right. Melanie!
All right. That was okay. All right, you know what we're going to do? We're going to head to Speaker's Corner on the road again. We're going to head to Montreal. We have a question for you. Listen up, ladies.
Hey, my name is Amanda.
And I'm Jesslyn.
And I'm Mara.
And we're from Vancouver.
Okay, we want to know how much say you guys actually have in the decision of the Spice Girls.
And girls' power rules, man.
Girl power!
Yeah! How much decision making do you guys have?
All of it, because we manage ourselves now.
All
so.
Yeah.
Don't
you think you need a manager? Don't you think it's time?
No.
I mean, we started out, we had a manager, and then we didn't have one, and then we had one again, and now we haven't got one again. And the thing is, we're happier now than we've ever been. Yeah. And it is harder, because we have to look after ourselves, but it's nice, because we do.
We've got helpers, we've got people that help us, right, and that advise us. But at the end of the day, we kind of call the shots on everything, and I think
that's... Sorry to cut you.
Go on.
But would you guys be really hard to manage, all? Because I could see there'd be some problems. I mean, if I was a manager...
I do think you can manage us.
I think we're very hard. Obviously, we're, you know, four individual people. We've got our... You know, we like to make our own decisions, so I think it'd be quite hard to keep up with us.
All right. We know what we do. We have an audience question. First question. Come on over here.
Yeah. Audience question.
All
right. Hi.
What's your name?
Genevieve.
All right. Where are you from?
Toronto.
Okay. And your question is?
How do you dress off stage as opposed to on?
The same.
Same.
More or less the same, but I did come in my dungarees today, but I thought I'd better make an effort for you lot, so that's why I've got these on.
Now, I think, you know, usually in our videos and when we do TVs and stuff like that, we wear the same sort of clothes that we wear when we're just out shopping or whatever, but in the show and our concert, they're a bit more elaborate, like a bit more
over
sparkly.
The top.
Mind you, I'm a bit sparkly today, aren't I?
Oh, that's nice.
But then if we do go out shopping, and obviously sometimes we need to go in a bit of a disguise, so we have to wear our hats and things like that.
There you go. All right, enjoy the rest of the show. We have another question.
Shall I tell you what hat it is?
Come on up.
So when you do see me.
All right, what's your name?
Caitlin.
All right, Caitlin, where are you from?
Mississauga.
All right, and your question is?
Hi.
What aspect have you... Oh, God.
It's all right.
That's all right.
All right. And go.
Okay. What aspect do you have more of your personal life in becoming famous? What aspect? Meaning, like, have you lost a lot of privacy?
Oh, right.
Good question.
I think when you become famous, you have to kind of take care of your private life a little bit more. And at the end of the day, there's nobody in your house with you or in your flat unless you want them to be. So your private life is still your private life. But as for things like if you want to go out socially, you have to be aware that people might recognise you or paparazzi might take a picture of you. So that's just one thing that you have to kind of handle. And that's like a small price to pay compared to what we get to do as Spice Girls anyway. So it's pretty good.
All right, there you go. All right, we're going to head to and take an email question.
Email.
Okay, it says, it's a short one. Hello, Spice Girls and Much. Do the Spice Girls think Master T is cute and why?
You like that question.
I didn't do that question.
You said did that yourself.
I did not set it up. Thank you, Douglas. I'll
do
pay you later.
Do you think he's cute, everybody?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then that little girl there said no.
You said no? Oh, thanks. Security,
and
she's
and
gone.
Very good as well. He's good, isn't he, at what he does as well?
Yes.
So give him a round of applause.
Thanks.
Hey!
You love it.
Yeah, I do. Thank you. All right, so from there, let's talk about the movie. I mean, were you guys surprised? It was like such a huge, huge movie. It's such a huge success.
I think we were surprised, actually, because, you know, when we were doing it, we were just having fun and sort of like acting ourselves. And it was good. It was number two in America under Titanic, which we were really, really happy about. So it was a very pleasant surprise.
Will there be another movie coming up?
Who knows?
Ooh, there could be. You know, it's something, again, that we've talked about. We really enjoyed doing the movie. And right now we're really enjoying the show. And then we've got the album. So we're just taking it one step at a time.
Is there anything that you really...
I'm in a Puff Daddy video. Can you not tell?
Yeah, he'll probably call you, too. All right, you know what? We have a phone call. And who's the caller?
Nadine?
Yeah. Hi, Nadine.
Hi. Hi. I think you guys are so cool, and I love the way you dress and everything. Okay, I have a question. I'm just wondering, you guys have accomplished so much through your time as Spice Girls, and I'm wondering if you have any more dreams or accomplishments that you'd like to have, like, to go on.
Any more dreams?
There's actually lots, even though, you know, we've been lucky enough. We have been lucky enough to achieve a lot of our dreams, but there's always more. I mean, personally as well, you know, we're four women and we like in families and stuff like that. So just personal stuff as well as, you know, we've got the third album. You never know, there might be another film or something like that. You know, there's so much more. You never stop. Never. That is one thing I'd like to say to everybody. Never ever stop dreaming.
And dreams can come true.
Yes.
All right. Do you have any regrets about your dreams? I mean, is there anything that you really, you know, say to yourself, you
yes,
know...
I regret wearing that orange and green G-string when I got a photograph, and I should have worn the blue and yellow one.
And all the guys I spoke to said, yeah, they agree. I'm kidding. No, do you regret that?
No, I'm only joking.
I think we don't, you know, ever regret anything. I think that, you know, everything is a learning experience.
It is.
And that's how you learn. As long as the mistakes are made by us and nobody else, then that's fine.
Okay, and the fact that I've got some blue thing hanging from me, does this mean like I'm an
honorary? Well, however, you might regret letting Melanie do that to your hair. You might regret that.
Yeah, no, you're probably. In the
She
gang.
Says with one in her hair, too.
All right, we're going to check out Rick, who is amongst all the fans out there. What's up, Rick? Hey, Master T, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Did you guys make this yourself?
Yep.
That's very nice. See that, Spice Girls? Isn't that nice artwork right there? You have a question. What's your name?
Carolyn.
And Carolyn, what's your question for the Spice Girls?
I'd like to know, who's the biggest shopaholic?
The biggest shopaholic? Who likes to spend the cash? Spice Girls.
Mel B. Oh, I think Vicky's quite... She counts
no.
me up now and again.
Mel B.
Okay, what's
the shopaholic?
Right. What's the most you've ever dropped on a shopping spree?
I am not a shopaholic. I'm in denial.
What's the most you've ever dropped on a shopping spree? The most. Come on. You can tell us in pounds and I'll figure it out in Canadian dollars. What's the most?
I wouldn't like to say because my mother will go mad with me.
Come on.
No, she's not saying. I'm not letting her.
No, I wouldn't like to say.
A lot of money. Okay, was it like...
A lot.
Like, okay, £10,000? More than that? £15,000?
I think we should change the subject.
I'm not telling you.
I'll tell you what, she's just bought a house, so things for houses are expensive.
Oh, yeah, okay. All right, we're going to take a question over here. One sec. All right. Hi there. How are you? What's your name?
Erin Farrell.
Okay, well, what's your question?
I really enjoyed your Spice World movie, and I'd like to know if you're going to be doing any more acting.
Well, actually, that's something we'd love to do. And, like, we have little talks between ourselves and talk about things. And we'd like to go and do things like, even maybe, like, just one of us go off and do a little bit in a film or, you know, somebody else. So you might see us in some of the films.
All right, I'm back. Okay,
I'm
so
getting beaten up by Melanie C. Phases at her.
I mean, aside
why
from...
Why don't we play a game? I know.
Okay, go
why
ahead.
Don't we start from here and we do a Mexican wave around the whole of the place?
Yay!
And everyone's going to do it. You know, right, so we'll start here. So you all have to stand up and do that. It's got to go all the way around. Okay? So we'll start from here. Are you ready? And go! Round the band! That was fun, wasn't
and
it?
I've got, like I've got a question. What's the score?
Oh.
Brazil.
Brazil, France.
Oh! Oh.
You well, wore your Brazil top today as well, didn't you?
Yeah, Brazil. All right, enough about the football then. All right, So the fact that you guys are here, I mean, how important it is? I mean, it must be important for you, I mean, to be intimate and close to your fans. I mean, what do you get back? Obviously, you must get a lot of feedback and all the rest of that stuff, but what does it do for you in terms of... Because some people can do this and it could be the most shallow process ever. But for you guys, it seems like it means a heck of a lot more.
I think, you know, we are really lucky because we have got really great fans. We've been through a lot as a band, and sometimes, especially in Britain, the media have tried to write us off. But the fans have always, like, they've always been there, and they've always been, like, really strong and, like, supportive of us. And then again, just even little things like if you're on stage and sometimes you're really tired, and then as soon as you get out there and the fans are there, and they're just sort of going, yay, Spice Girls! And it just gives you so much energy. It's amazing.
But if you think about it, you know, I think the only reason we're here doing this is because of our fans. They're the ones who buy our records, they're the ones that we write our lyrics for, and, you know, they're the ones we're here for, really.
There you go. Okay, Victoria. I don't know how I missed it earlier, but can I see that rock on your finger? Now, how many carats would we be talking about here?
A lot.
Oh.
Yeah.
Look at that. That's a serious. You know, they say you should, like, you know, as a man, you should, like, do.
I can punch good with it.
you should, like, as a guy, if you're buying a ring, I think it should be, like, what, one paycheck or what, a couple paychecks or something like that? That's some serious paychecks.
Yeah.
It is. All right. All right. So he's not going to come out, is he, Mr.
No, he's not.
He's not. He's not. All right. That's good. Yeah.
He's like the invisible man.
He's all right.
He's
not gonna come out. All right. So we have a phone call. All right. Who's on the line?
Hello.
Hi there.
Hi.
Hello.
Who's this? This is Nipsey.
All right. And your question for the Spice Girls?
I want to know who their favorite Backstreet Boy is and why.
Backstreet Boys.
Favorite, yeah. Backstreet Boy.
We were watching them today on TV, and they're really good.
Yeah, we like their stuff.
Yeah, we say that. We reckon that Backstreet Boys are the best boy band.
Definitely.
They are, definitely.
Their music is wicked.
Yes, it is.
All right, you know what we're going to do? Thank you.
Okay.
Sorry I cut you off there. We're actually going to head to the window.
That's rude.
All right, I'm sorry. Sorry, posh. I'm going to run to the window. I'm going to take a question at the window. So let me just run out here. Okay. One second. Hi. Whoa, my thing's dropping off here. One second here. Hold that for me. Pick that up for me. Thank you. Pass that back to me. All right, what's your name?
My name's Ryan, Diva Spice.
All right, Diva Spice. What time did you get here?
I got here at about 11:30 yesterday morning.
So you slept over?
Absolutely. It was great. We've got a whole family out here. It's wonderful. So, okay, I got two things to say. First of all, the Spice Girls always talk about girl power. I'd like to know what kind of power you guys represent to those of us who aren't girls, i.e. women, boys, guys, men. And second of all, Mel B, I'm a diva, you're a diva. Come on here so I can give your hand a big diva kiss.
Hello.
There she comes. All right, hold on. There we go, all right, great. All right, are you guys still having a good time out here? Make some noise for me.
He didn't answer the question, did he?
We got lots more. The Spice Girls are going to perform real soon, so stick around on the intimate and interactive featuring the Spice Girls. Two more back. Beautiful Spice Girls fans, are you in the house? Make some noise for me. Come on. I want to see the section over here. Section on my left side. Make some noise for me. Come on. In the middle, make some noise for me. Come on. On the right-hand side, make some noise. Let me see them. We are ready for another Spice Girls live performance, and they have agreed to come out here and sing to all of you Spice Girls fans. So let's hear it. Get those hands clapping for the Spice Girls live and intimate interaction. Come on.
You take a hitch, I run a mile.
everybody. A nice slow one. Why don't you all sit down so everybody out there can see, so we can see them. That's better.
Question here. Yeah, who has a question? Anyone have a question? You got a question? What's your question?
If you can give one word of advice to the rest of the youth of the world, what would it be? If they could say something to all the children of the world, what would it be?
Okay, I got a question here. If you could say something to all the children of the world, What would you want to say?
Well, I'm not, basically, all we want to say is we have got the best fans in the world and we love it here in Toronto. You are wicked.
I just want to know, everybody, if you've had a good time, say Spice Girls. Uh-oh, she's loose, look out. Okay, let's take another question here. You have a question? What's your question?
I just want to say, I love the Spice Girls, and I especially love Victoria, and I just want to wish them the best of luck, and I hope that they're going to do great in the future. I love the Spice Girls, I love Victoria.
Okay, good for you. Do you have any other questions? You have a question here? What's your question?
What do the Spice Girls plan on doing after the touring?
Okay, let me have... Okay, I got a question for you guys. Everybody, you can take this one. They someone asked, though, what do you plan on doing after the tour? Mm-hmm. What do you plan on doing after the tour?
After the tour, we're going to be going in the studio to do our third album!
All right. I think I've just got enough time. Okay, keep it down for 1 second, all right? Keep it down. I have enough time to just say thank you, Emma. Thank you, Victoria. Thank you, Mel B. Thank you, Mel C. Thank you for making this a wicked, intimate, and interactive. I want to thank all the fans inside. Make some noise for all the fans inside. Thank you all. And especially, I want to thank all you fans out here. Once again, if you've had a good time, I want to hear you make some noise for me. Let them hear you. We want to thank you all for coming out. Some of you that stayed overnight, we want to thank you. Hope you've had a great, safe, and positive time here for this intimate and interactive featuring the Spice Girls. Take care, enjoy yourselves. Peace.